Nanomedicine company Nanobiotix has announced a new area of development, immuno-oncology, after establishing preliminary preclinical proof of concept with the lead product NBTXR3 for its new program. We are joined by Chief Executive Laurent Levy to find out more. Hello, Laurent.
Hello.
Now, Laurent, how does immuno-oncology fit in with the development of NBTXR3?
So that's a very logical step into our development. We want to develop NBTXR3 in combination with radiotherapy, trying to establish a new type of radiotherapy, meaning transforming radiotherapy into radiotherapy plus nanoparticles. And we have this big standalone development where we are trying to combine both to make a more efficient radiotherapy in killing tumor cells and in providing benefit for patients. That's the core business of Nanobiotix, to make radiotherapy more efficient. And on the other side, we see that radiotherapy is taking more and more space into the immuno-oncology field. So that's why we've started to see if NBTXR3 could bring something in it. And that's what we think we've done.
Okay, so about immuno-oncology, it's obviously a very exciting area of development for many pharmaceutical companies out there. Why this in particular when the company was focusing on nanomedicine?
Well, I think immuno-oncology is one of the tools that could help to treat patients. But so far, that's a tool that is really working on few patients, because there is a key point in immuno-oncology is a tumor can be recognized by the immune system. If yes, boosting the immune system with the immuno-oncology drug may have sense to make it efficient and to turn your immune system into a cure. The problem today, and that's why we see more and more combination in the immuno-oncology field, is that most of the tumor do not respond, because you need to do something at the tumor level to make it express something that could be recognized by the immune system. And that's where radiotherapy is coming into place, where there are more and more evidence showing that when you irradiate a tumor or a cancer cell, you're creating some kind of immunogenic cell death. And this cell death will allow the recognition of the tumor by the immune system. So here, the rationale to use NBTXR3 will be, we had this product and we try to improve what radiotherapy can do. And if it is doable, then you can have a product that could be used to create some kind of in situ vaccination into patients, and to turn the patients that are not responsive to immuno-oncology to patients that could be responsive to it. And I think we also have a very interesting business case here, is that when you use radiotherapy, it's the same radiotherapy for everyone. Every immuno-oncology drug has access to radiotherapy. So there is no specific competitive advantage in doing so. But if you had a product such as NBTXR3 in the game, which is a patented product, then you could offer a very unique combination and bring a very key business benefit and advantage to the one that will make this combination.
Okay, Laurent, so to sum up, NBTXR3 with immuno-oncology works by turning the tumor itself into a vaccine.
Correct.
Okay. So let's talk about the global clinical development for NBTXR3 then. Where do you stand currently?
Well, I think the company remains focused on its clinical development. That is here to improve the benefit of radiotherapy. And we are our complete set of data that should be presented soon in a number of clinical trials. So just in the order, the head and neck clinical trial that is currently running, phase 1 and 2, we should present the first complete set of data very soon now. And then a bit later on, there will be the interim readout of the clinical data phase 2-3 registration trial on soft tissue sarcoma. That will be roughly for the summer. And based on those data, if they are positive, then we will be able to file for a CE mark that should lead us, expecting everything is going well, for the first market approval by the end of this year. And on the second part of the year, second semester, then we'll have the liver met clinical trial and the hepatocellular clinical trial phase 1 that will start delivering initial data on safety and feasibility. So we'll have a very rich year. And if we had also the phase 1-2 in prostate cancer, that should start very soon in the US with the first patient injected. We will communicate a bit more on that on the second half of the year. then we'll have a year with a numerous clinical data.
Okay, Laurent, thank you very much for your time today.
Thank you.
Laurent Levy, Chief Executive at Nanobiotix.